Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome America's favorite family of Southern gospel, the Hoppers! It's good to be in our great state of North Carolina, our home state, and we appreciate this opportunity. I hope the few songs that we sing for you be a blessing to you. And so many people, as I said earlier tonight, requested songs that we kind of dismissed several years ago, but this was the number one song in 1990. And many of you know we're from just a few miles from here up in the Rockingham County area. I was born and raised on a farm. I'm one of 11 children, 8 boys and 3 girls. Didn't have electric lights when I was a kid. How many folks remember that, when you didn't have electric lights? My dad used to walk up the steps each night.
I still don't have them.
He's too tight to turn his on, the reason he don't have them. But he'd call our names out because we couldn't see him, nor could he see us. But he'd call our names out, and I'd say, "Here I am, Dad." In the age of 22 and a half, one day, I received a letter from Washington, D.C. It said, "Greetings, we have selected you to serve in our armed forces." I didn't try to escape the draft. I took off to a place called Fort Leonardwood, Missouri. For the next 9 miserable weeks of my life, every morning they'd say, "Private Hopper," and I'd say, "Here I am." I've answered the roll all my life, but there's one more roll call I'm going to answer to. It's not going to be very long. The Bible says when Gabriel blows the trumpet, we rise to meet him in the air. We're going to be changed in a split second from here to there. Listen.
On that resurrection morning, when the redeemed are gathering in, I'll be in that royal number when they call my name, when they all join in. And
and we rise up in the air in less time than a split second. We'll all be changed from here to there.
Some years ago, we recorded a song, and right after that, I read in a book our story. Billy Graham had a great crusade in the great state of Texas at a football stadium. Over 35,000 people was there that night. The invitation was given, and not one person came forward. And they said that Billy Graham got back to his hotel room, and he couldn't understand. He began to share this with a friend. He said, "I don't understand it. Did Cliff Barris sing the right song at the invitation?" And they said, "Yes, Billy, he sung the right song, but you left out the cross tonight in your message." And you know, folks, you either accept the finished work at the cross or you reject it. I chose to accept it many, many years ago, and I want you to listen to a great song. Think about the words of it. It says, "Anchor to the power of that cross." Sing it, kid.
You know this. Sing along on the chorus.
Aimlessly floating, spiritually withdrawn, life's winds and waves and rising tides have left you forlorn. You say your ship can't stand another storm, and the final wave seems near. Just anchor deep, yes, to the solid rock. Let the captain handle your fears.
Anchor to the power of the cross. Anchor to the power of the cross. Keep your eyes on the master. When drifting and storm tossed, anchor to the power of the cross.
We're troubled on every side, but not crushed and broken. Yes, perplexed, but not desperate. So all is not hopeless. I know that God has not forsaken. Though cast down, we're not destroyed, 'cause the captain stood the test of time, and he is still Lord.
Through the solid rock of ages, I'll hold my ground. When changing winds blow again and toss me around,
soul to a source that will never fail. Stand firm, weather the storm, 'cause the cross will bring all.
Anchor to the power of
love that song. I love the message. Aren't you? Thank you, darling. Aren't you glad for the message in that song? Last night we were in Cleveland, Ohio, and there was a radio station there that was not a Christian station, and we were doing, they were doing interviews, and they came and grabbed Dean and myself, and the rest of them I think were eating, and he said, "Tell me what's so different about your kind of music." I said, "In our music, the lyrics can change a life." I said, "I don't know of any other music that the lyrics can touch and change a life like Southern gospel music." And I'm glad tonight for the cross and the power of the cross. Spoke with a lady not long ago. Her husband and his first wife were not able to reconcile their marriage. They split up. The man walked away from a son. He had not seen him for 18 years. We were singing this next song in a church. There's a line in this song that says, "Go ask the child who has a dad to love away the hurt he had before this man called Jesus touched their lives." The man heard that line of this song, and he determined in his heart right there that he was going to go and find his son he had not seen for 18 years. And he began the search, and through over 2 or 3 months, he was able to find out where his son was. And he wrote his son a letter. And the son was really staying at the grandparents' home of his former wife. And so he wrote the letter, and it just happened the grandparents were out of town. So when the postman brought the letter, the boy opened it. He got it out of the mailbox, and he opened it, and he began to read. And he began to read this letter from his dad. And he called his dad. They set a time to meet, and his dad was real nervous. He says, "I don't know how he's going to accept me or if he will accept me." And when he got to the meeting with his son just threw his arms around his neck, and he says, "You don't know how long I've waited for this day to meet my dad." I know there might be a line in this song tonight that might touch you in a special way, but you have to listen real close to every word, because it says, "Go ask somebody that's been touched by the Lord, and they'll be a blessing to you." Don't ask me to explain for you how one can start again, how hardened hearts could soften like a child. Don't ask me how to reason out all the mysteries of life, or how to face all of its problems with a smile. Go ask the man who's found the way through tangled roads back home to stay, when all communications were destroyed. Go ask the child who's walking now, who once was then somehow her useless legs were made to jump for joy. Go ask the one whose burned out mind has been restored, and I think you'll find the questions not important as before. He's good or bad, I only know the guilt I had is gone, and I can't tell you anymore.
this man called Jesus touch their lives. Go ask the one whose fears have fled, whose churning heart was quieted when someone whispered peace to all her strife. Go ask the man to tell you more, whose life was just a raging war inside himself until the Savior came. I don't pretend to be so wise.
Here's an old song we'd like to sing again for you tonight. It's titled Heavenly Sunrise.
Celebrate.
Thank you so much. As I said, we recorded some of the old songs that we no longer have on video. And if you never met my family, my youngest son plays the drums. His name is Michael Hopper. This is his lovely wife for 2.5 years. Her name is Denise Hopper. This is my other son. Just because we're family don't mean they don't get on your nerves. And I got one nerve, and he stays on it all the time. This is my other son. His name is Dean Hopper, and he's married to this beautiful lady for 10.5 years. Her name is Kim Green Hopper. How about a nice stand for Dean and Kim? And a special thanks to Mr. Frank Mills for being on this. Give Mr. Frank Mills a nice hand this evening.
Yeah.
This is my pride and joy. The Hopper brothers started singing in 1957. I went to my first concert in 56, and gospel music just kind of changed my life when I heard the States from the Blackwood Brothers and a family called the Spear Family. And I'm telling you, they blessed my heart. And I went back home and I got some brothers together. I have seven of them, and four of us started singing in 1957. So this year marks 42 years in gospel music for me. And I don't regret a mile. She joined us a year after that in 1958, playing the piano. And she was the best in our community. In fact, she was the only one in our community. And we celebrated the anniversary last week. She and I have been married 38 years, believe it or not. And And you know, we eat out a lot anyway, but I took her to her favorite place in Greensboro for the anniversary. And of course, she never picks up the mail, so I went by the mailbox and we had, I won't say hundreds of cards, but many, many cards, you know, congratulating our 38th year in marriage. And so I thought, let's take those along with me to the restaurant. And she loves to read mail, I'm telling you. So I said, Connie, here's a bag of cards. And so we give the waitress our order, and she began to read those cards. And I kind of got emotional. Looking back 38 years with this lady, I just kind of got emotionally, and I thought, well, you know, there's nobody around, the music was playing, and we was in a dark corner, and I just looked over to her, and I said, Connie, you know what, I'm proud of you. And she never looked up. She just kept reading those cards. And so in a moment, I said a little loud, I said, Connie, you know what, I'm proud of you. And she never looked up. She just kept on reading. By that time, I got a little provoked, and the teardrop that was in my eye had dried up. And I said it real loud. I said, Connie, I'm proud of you. And she stopped reading. And she reached up, and she took her glasses off. She looked me in the eye and said, yes, and I'm tired of you, too. But I appreciate her. Her name is Connie. My name is Claude. This makes up all the hoppies. You're glad to see them all this evening. You know, for 38 years, you know, when she asked me to marry her, and I said, yes, ma'am, I will. And she picked me out of those eight boys, and she asked me if I enjoyed her playing, and I said, yes, ma'am. And I've been saying yes, ma'am, for 38 years, and she whispered in my ear, she said, I want you to sing another song. So I said, yes, ma'am. Let's do. It's time for a miracle. It's time for revival. It's time.
You're desperate for mercy, but none can be found. There's an answer coming to you. Hear it breaking through the clouds. Your appointment for deliverance is right about now. It's time for a miracle. Been sleeping on the job, unaware of the hurting of those that Satan has robbed. If we would bind up the wounded and love the outcast in the crowd, we'd see renewal and revival.
Old time salvation. Let the devil be
contrary to what my friend said over here tonight, I've spent 42 years in my life, and a lot of folks come by a table night after night, and they start requesting songs for the Hoppers to sing, and we appreciate that. And I've noticed in particular the songs that people ask is either features Dean or Kim or Connie. People don't know how cruel they could really be. As I just said, I've sung 42 years of my life. When I sing, I don't get standing ovations, and people don't pitch babies out of the balcony. But I've enjoyed my singing. I really do, and I want to dedicate it to the MC tonight. And this is my testimony. And I was down at our rest home. This actually happened where I went to elementary school. They turned that into a rest home, and they renovated it. And I went down there this past Christmas just to visit some of the old folks, the folks I've known all my life.
You went to school with them, didn't you?
No, I'm not that old. But I've known them all my life, and I came by Mrs. Williams' bed, and she's 96 years old. And she was laying there, and she looked like an angel. And I just walked up to her, and I said, "Hi, Miss Williams, do you know who I am?" And she kind of looked puzzled, and I said, "You know, I'm married to Connie, and I've been singing gospel music for over 40 years. Now, do you know who I am?" And she looked at me and says, "No, I do not, but if you'll go down to the nurse's station, they'll tell you who you are." That'll do something to your ego. Well, I hope that you'll enjoy my testimony. He says, "I want to walk. Sometimes my steps are slow. I've been a long time traveling, but I'm not discouraged though. Well, I'm on my way to glory land, in the right direction I know. I got a long way to go, but I'm happy on my journey home. Well, I want to be a little more like Jesus every day. I want to make a lot of progress on the King's Highway. I want to say a little, give a little, pray a little, live a little more like Jesus every day. I want to tell him his love wherever I go. He's a friend of mine. I love him so, though the journey's hard, still I go on my journey home. And before you start on your journey, make sure your flanks unfurl, and you better get ready to meet the Savior before you leave this world. There'll be no excuses accepted when you stand before God's throne. You better fall on your knees and confession on your journey home. Well, I want to be a little more like Jesus every day. I want to make a lot of progress on the King's Highway. I want to say a little, give a little, pray a little, live a little more like Jesus every day. I want to tell him his love wherever I go. He's a friend of mine. I love him so, though the journey's hard, still I go on my journey home. I want to be a little more like Jesus every day. I want to make highway, I want to say a little, give a little, pray a little, live a little, on my journey home, on my journey home.
I want to be
a little more like Jesus every day. I want to make a little progress on the King's Highway. I want to say a little, give a little, pray a little, live a little, more like Jesus every day. I want to tell him his love wherever I go. He's a friend of mine. I love him so, though the journey's hard, still I go. That's the best hand I ever received.
You see that lady up there? She threw her baby up in the air when you sang that.
Seriously, I guess we get more requests. We recorded this song two times in our career. Jesus left us some great commandments, some great instructions. The Bible says he had given the disciples the final instructions, and he ascended into the clouds from the Mount of Olives. The Bible says that two men appeared in white apparel and said, "You men of Galilee, why do you stand and gaze? Because the same Jesus you see going up, woo, he's coming back in like manner." I wasn't there when he went up, but praise God, we're all going to be here when he comes back down. 1 John says, "It doth not appear what we shall be, but we know when he shall appear, we shall be like him." Listen.
When Jesus was here, he gave us the words of eternal life, and he gave us his peace, and he said, "I'll not leave you alone." And though I wasn't there when the multitude, they watched him ascend.
That's it, Kim.
Two angels in white, they announced that he would come back again. What a blessing it was just to be part of that crowd that was gathered there that day. Can you imagine what that was like? Just to see him go up and in clouds, see him taken away. But I know in my heart that a greater blessing waits now for I know that I'll be like
Jesus, he will embrace me in his arms, in the arms of Christ my Savior. Oh, there are 10,000 charms.
It's
shouting time in heaven, a sinner that's lost is found. It's shouting time in heaven, salvation has been brought down. No wonder the angels rejoice to know my sins have been covered by the crimson glow. And now I'm feeling fine. I'm walking on the highway with my Lord. My name is written down in the courts above. It's shout time in heaven. Oh yes, it's shout time. Rejoice to know my sins have been covered by the crimson glow. And now I'm feeling fine. I'm walking on the highway with my Lord. My name is written down in the courts of my heart. It's shout time in heaven. Oh yes, it's shout time. It's shout time in heaven. A sinner once lost is found. It's shout time in heaven. Salvation has been brought down. No wonder the angels rejoice to know my sins have been covered by the crimson glow. And now I'm feeling fine. Walking on the highway with my Lord. My name is written down in the courts of love. It's shouting time in heaven. Oh yes, it's shouting time. No wonder the angels rejoice to know my sins have been covered by the crimson glow. And now I'm feeling fine. Walking on the highway with my Lord. It's shout time in heaven. Oh,
The Naples and the Hoppers!